My fellow high-end desktop enthusiasts, we've been tricked, duped, hornswoggled, if you will. It all started back in 2017 when AMD came out of nowhere with the initial launch of Threadripper, dismantling Intel's stranglehold on the high-end desktop space so thoroughly that Team Blue still hasn't recovered. And it was perhaps for that very reason that just 2 years later, in 2019, AMD bamboozled us all again, but in a negative sort of way this time, with the launch of third-gen Threadripper and its attendant platform, STRX4, which we were assured would feature long-term support for future Threadripper generations. So imagine our disappointment when AMD just never did that, instead focusing on their much more pricey Threadripper Pro options when they eventually launched the Threadripper 5000 series, sending the enthusiast high-end desktop space back into limbo, with nothing exciting on the horizon, even after Threadripper 7000 rumors picked up steam in recent months and weeks. Because the cynic inside all of us said, the Threadripper 7000 series would undoubtedly be more of the same, super pricey Pro Series chips that are simply impractical for even the most enthusiastic of high-end desktop enthusiasts, and probably only launching via pre-built OEM systems anyway. But I'm happy to say that those assumptions were completely wrong. So let's cover today's most relevant info as quickly as possible right up front. AMD is launching both Threadripper Pro and Threadripper Non-Pro next month on November 21st, at which point you will be able to buy non-Pro CPUs directly from e-tailers and OEM pre-built systems with Pro Series CPUs from OEMs like Dell, Lenovo, Supermicro, or HP. AMD has revealed three Threadripper Non-Pro models, a 24-core 7960X that will cost $1,500, a 32-core 7970X for $2,500, and a 64-core 7980X that will be $5,000. Expensive, yes, and more on pricing in a moment, but let's stick to the raw data for now. The Threadripper Pro counterparts do not have pricing info as of yet, but for SKUs there are four. Just add Pro and a 5 and a W to the non-Pro models, and there you have it. 7965WX, 7975WX, and 7985WX for the 24, 32, and 64 core models. And finally, the beastly flagship 96 core 192 thread 7995WX. This chart also reveals a couple ways AMD is differentiating the Pro and non-Pro versions. First with memory, as Pro will go up to 8 channel and non-Pro is limited to quad channel, and also PCI Express lanes, which are reduced by more than 50%, up to 128 PCIe 5.0 lanes for Pro and a mere 48 available for the non-Pro platforms. Now that's still twice as many PCIe 5.0 lanes for Threadripper non-Pro as you get on the mainstream Ryzen platform, but this will likely be a sticking point for folks who actually need a lot of PCIe bandwidth. They'll be pushed towards the Pro platform. Speaking of platforms, there are two of them, both using the STR5 socket, but with varying capabilities based on the chipset. WRX90 is the Pro platform that will only work with Threadripper Pro CPUs, and it gets 8-channel memory support and all the PCIe lanes, 144 usable, with 128 of them being PCIe Gen 5. TRX50, meanwhile, is the non-Pro high-end desktop platform, and it's limited to quad-channel memory support and 88 usable PCIe lanes, with 48 max being PCIe Gen 5. Overclocking is supported on both platforms, and interestingly, TRX50 supports the Pro CPUs too, so if you really need 96 cores, but you don't require 8-channel memory or all those PCIe lanes, you could drop a 7995WX into a TRX50 motherboard, and it will still work. Lastly, you should note that AMD has gone with DDR5 RDIMMs for the memory, which means ECC support, which is good for many workstation-oriented tasks, but that does mean this platform is not compatible with the DDR5 UDIMM modules that mainstream AMD Ryzen and Intel Core desktop platforms currently use. So don't plan to swap in RAM from your existing system, you will need a new memory kit. So let's talk pricing for a moment, since I don't want to imply that a $5,000 CPU is somehow now affordable just because it doesn't say Pro on the heat spreader. I think considering cost per core is a good way to approach this, and specifically cost per Zen 4 core, since that's what Threadripper 7000 and Ryzen 7000 series CPUs are using. Ryzen mainstream CPUs currently use 1 or 2 8-core CCDs under the heat spreader, whereas Threadripper 7000 can use 8 or up to 12 8-core CCDs. So the Ryzen 9 7950X is the current best bang for the buck for a Zen 4 core on the mainstream platform. It's a 16-core CPU that typically sells for $600. Recently, it's even been down to $580 or so. That's about $37 per core, sort of as a starting off point. By comparison, if we want to look at the most recent Threadripper offerings, that would be the 64-core Threadripper Pro 5995WX. That was $6,500 originally. Now it's selling for around $5,800, and that's about $90 to $100 per core. So you can see there's a pretty significant cost per core increase just by switching from the mainstream platform to Threadripper. Of course, historically, if we go all the way back to the Threadripper 1000 series, the 16-core Threadripper 1950X launched in August 2017 for $1,000. That's $62.50 per core. So again, that is a bit of a premium, if not quite as bad as Threadripper 5000 series, going from $30 to $40 a core for mainstream to $60 to $70 a core for Threadripper. But I actually did the math on those other CPUs before I even calculated the cost per core for the new Threadripper 7000 series ones, and the best price per core is the 24-core Threadripper 7960X for $1,500, and that is also $62.50 per core, basically the same price per core that the 1950X launched at, and I feel like that must be at least somewhat intentional on AMD's part. Of course, with this new lineup going from the 24-core at $1,500 to the 32-core at $2,500, you're paying $1,000 for those 8 more cores versus $500 per 8 cores for the 24-core model. So for the 32 and 64-core variants, you're paying $78 per core, definitely a premium over the, let's say, entry-level Ryzen 7000 series CPU. But speaking of entry-level Threadripper, I was vaguely obsessed with making an entry-level Threadripper build back in the day. The price for that system, for anyone who just was trying to get onto the Threadripper platform without spending too much money, was $1,850. Granted, that was with the 12-core model, and there's no 12-core model this time around. But my feeling for this generation, with a $1,500 base price for the CPU, probably at least $500 for a motherboard plus GPU and all the other things you need. So that makes it probably $3,000 to $4,000 for entry level Threadripper 7000. Still, that's a lot easier to stomach than some of the previous options that were available. And then I guess the last price comparison you might want to make would be for the new Threadripper 64-core, the 7980X, and that one's going to be selling for $5,000 versus the previous generation Threadripper Pro 5995WX. That was $6,500 or $1,500 more for the 64-core variant, and that used Zen 3 and not Zen 4. So if that leaves you wondering why is the 5995WX Zen 3 64-core $6,500 for the Pro version versus $5,000 for the Zen 4 64-core, just non-Pro, what's the difference? What makes a Pro CPU a Pro CPU, and why does AMD feel like they can charge more for them? What Pro CPUs get that non-Pro CPUs don't is a bunch of work that goes on behind the scenes, specifically to test, validate, certify, and even optimize these niche enterprise software solutions that many companies rely on to get their jobs done. AMD provided a list of these software solutions indicating which ones are currently certified, which ones have been optimized. I imagine they're going to continue to work at this to add more check marks to places where they don't currently exist. But a lot of the software on this list you've never heard about, but it's used by companies who might make a lot of money and might have a lot of money to spend on their hardware. And those companies probably do not want to build and maintain their own systems. They want to work with an OEM or an enterprise system integrator because business customers want hardware that works and has full tech support, which is what you're paying for with those Pro models. But while it is often worth it for businesses to pay for that level of support and compatibility, the Threadripper non-Pro lineup must always try not to overlap with that Pro market too much, because they don't want Pro market customers to be like, oh, let's just save a few $1,000 and buy the non-Pro solution. And that is the reason why these Threadripper non-Pro CPUs do have cut down features, like not having 8-channel memory support and having fewer PCIe lanes, because they think those are features that specifically those Pro level customers who want to spend a bit more money for that level of service are willing to spend that much more money for. To round this video out, I have a hodgepodge of data that didn't seem to fit within any of the sections I've already gone through. First off, clock speeds are much better. We can see the previous Threadripper 5000 series topped out at about 4.5 gigahertz. These new chips go up to 5.1 to 5.3 gigahertz, and yes, overclocking is supported, so I'm kind of curious to see how much further beyond that they can go. Although historically, with as many cores and dies as Threadripper has, devices, overclocking hasn't always been its strong point. We have a few platform block diagrams that I'll put on the screen right now for you guys in case anyone wants to pause and take a closer look. There's additional support that didn't exist with the 5000 series, such as AVX512 support, as well as AES 256-bit encryption for security. And while there are many different ways that one might use a Threadripper system to take advantage of all of the computing horsepower under the hood, I thought this use case was an interesting one. AMD installed 6 of their Alveo MA35D streaming video cards, and that allowed a Threadripper 7000 system to simultaneously process 500 720p video streams all at once. So you could start up your own Twitch competitor, I suppose. But guys, that is pretty much gonna wrap it up for this video. I must say that in a week when I've been somewhat disappointed by some of the CPU launches that have come to light, I was very excited to hear more about Threadripper, and I hope this has helped explain things a little bit more for you guys, so you know what's coming when the launch happens on November 21st. I'll post links to relevant stuff where necessary down in the video's description. While you're down there, you can also check out my store at paulshardware.net, where I have shirts, mugs, pint glasses, and more to help support my channel and get yourself some awesome merch. If you haven't done so and you enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up button on your way out. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already for more videos coming at you real soon, just like this one. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you all in the next video.